But today we're discussing grains and why they're very inflammatory to the body, and they're going to be energy zappers. They're going to cause a lot of inflammation. There's a lot of issues with grains. One of the main issues with grains is that they're prepared improperly. That's right. So most grains, you got to think, we're also going to be speaking about beans, legumes, stuff like that, in future videos. But keep in mind that a grain is a seed-like plant. So when that plant is growing in nature, those grains are supposed to sort of drop to the floor or the ground, and then they're going to germinate, they're going to sprout from there. Now, the plant has a natural defense mechanism that goes around these seeds called phytates and lectins and these different anti-nutrients. And why that's there is because if that wasn't there, anytime these seeds would fall to the ground, animals would just come, they would eat them, and then there would be no way for the plant to keep reproducing. So this needs to be there to prevent animals from eating the seeds. But just like it prevents animals from eating the seeds, it's also not so healthy for us either. So in nature, when it starts to sprout, that seed needs to be soaked, and then from there needs to be sprouted. Now, so that's the best way to prepare grains. But overall, grains are going to be very, very inflammatory in the body. Most are prepared the wrong way, so they're very high in lectins, they're very high in phytates. So not only are they physically irritating to the digestive tract, they can also cause other issues. And why they're called anti-nutrients is because especially phytic acid and lectins, they will bind to minerals that you're eating. So let's say you're eating a healthy plate of vegetables and you happen to have some grain with that vegetables. Maybe you're eating vegetables with some rice. Right? If that rice is not prepared properly, that rice could literally be snatching the very minerals that you're hoping to get from the vegetables that you're eating. So the easiest thing to do is to just remove the grains out of the diet completely. So this accounts for bread, this accounts for pasta, this accounts for the typical stuff we hear, but this also accounts for other things like quinoa and brown rice and oatmeal, foods that we think are very healthy, but there is nothing that you have to go to grains to get nutritional-wise that you can't get from meat, vegetables, and fruit. So there's really nothing that grains offer that makes them so special. So therefore, it's a little better, in my opinion, to just try to avoid them as much as possible. And if you're gonna include grains when you do, make sure that they're soaked, make sure that they're sprouted. And all that basically means is, let's say you had some quinoa, you need to soak it in water first, and then you rinse that after it sits overnight, and then you let that sit for like another day or so, and that will start to sprout. And then from there, then you can cook that. That's the ideal, but as you can see, it takes a couple of days just to prepare the grain to even cook it. So it's just much easier, in my own experience, my own opinion. You could try this out for yourself, but it's much easier to just sort of remove the grains and not even try to focus on trying to do all that. Just easier to focus on meat, vegetables, fruit, and some nuts and seeds. So keep in mind, as we're going through the weeks, each one of these actions stacks on top of the next. So each one of these actions is a little bit of an upgrade. So we always look at everything and we say, how do we make an upgrade to this? How do we make this a little better? And so we're constantly going to be tweaking little things like that that are going to have a huge, huge, huge impact on your energy, your focus, your performance, your productivity, as well as how your body feels. So grains are very inflammatory. Those are one of those foods that will cause muscle pain, joint pain, stiffness. So when we remove those, you're going to feel so much better. That's what I have for you in this video. I'll see you on the very next one.